Hey, second grade friends, and welcome to my new music room. What are some things you notice that are similar or different from our music room at school? Oh, yeah. You're right about that. Well, with all the things that we have here in what's my basement, I think that we can make lots of great music together. In fact, let's start right now. Do you know this song? Yes. Probably started singing along, didn't you? I thought I heard you singing along. The song is Witch, witch, fell in a ditch, picked up a penny and thought she was rich. Witch, witch, fell in a ditch, picked up a penny and thought she was rich. Are you my children? Yes, we're your children. Are we your children? No, you old witch. Friends. Oh, I love that song. Well, you know what we can do now. We have to sing it together. Witch, witch, fell in a ditch, picked up a penny and thought she was rich. Witch, witch, fell in a ditch, picked up a penny and thought she was rich. Then the witch asks, are you my children? The kids say, yes, we're your children. But the witch asks again, are you my children? No, you old witch! And then they run. And I wonder if you can be the children and I'll be the witch. First, we sing together. Witch, witch, fell in a ditch, picked up a penny and thought she was rich. Witch, witch, fell in a ditch, picked up a penny and thought she was rich. Are you my children? Are you my children? And then you ran away. Oh my goodness. And I try to find you. I see you're trying to hide, but I can see you there. Come out, come out. Okay, friends, come on back. I wonder if this time you could be the witch. I'll be the children.
Witch, witch, fell in a ditch, picked up a penny and thought she was rich. Witch, witch, fell in a ditch, picked up a penny and thought she was rich. Yes, we're your children.
No, you old witch! Did you get me? I don't know. I tried to run. Phew. Either way, I think that that was fun. But not as much fun as a dance party. Time to go. Come with me. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, that was fun too. Well, now I think it's time to relax. And what a better way to relax than a story. In fact, maybe you've heard of this story before. Peter and the Wolf. This story has lots of instruments, and I thought I could play them for you. Well, I wish I could play them with my actual hands, but instead, the sounds that we hear will have to do. I wonder if you notice some things about some of the characters. What instruments you might hear for Peter, what you might hear for the wolf, what you might hear for the other characters in our story. Early one morning, Grandfather was dreaming and Peter tiptoed out from his cottage into the garden. He tiptoed past the duck. Peter opened the gate and walked out into the meadow. As he walked into the meadow, there was a little bird perched at the top of a tall, tall tree. The bird was Peter's friend. "Good morning, Peter. Good morning, Peter. Good morning, Peter," chirped the bird. "What a fine day." Well, the duck noticed that Peter didn't close the gate, so the duck decided to waddle on out into the meadow as well. How nice to start the day with a little trip into the pond. And the duck began to swim about. Well, the little bird and the duck were friends, but sometimes they teased each other. So the bird began to chirp as it flew down to the pond. "What kind of bird are you if you can't fly? What kind of bird are you if you can't fly?" Well, the duck said, "What kind of bird are you if you can't swim? What kind of bird are you if you can't swim?" Suddenly, out came the cat. "Oh, I love little birds," said the cat. "And this one is so busy teasing the duck that perhaps I can start my day with a lovely breakfast." "Look out," said Peter. He was trying to save his friend the bird, and the bird flew up into the tree. The cat just missed. Meanwhile, Peter's grandfather woke up, and he came stomping through the garden and into the meadow. "How many times do I have to tell you? You do not go into the meadow. What do you think is going to happen? In fact, you might come across a wolf." Grandfather led Peter back to the garden and locked the gate. Well, it was just then that guess what appeared. The wolf. Out of the trees, across the meadow, crept the wolf. The cat was the first to spot it. In a flash, the cat ran up the tree. Right up behind, the bird flew up into the sky. The duck didn't notice. The duck was waddling around until it could feel some breathing upon its feathers, on its back, and it turned around. And what did it see? The duck waddled as quickly as it possibly could across the meadow, around the trees, up and down the hills. The wolf was getting closer and closer and closer and closer and closer. Until he swallowed the duck whole. The wolf licked its lips and headed back to the tree. He paced around it and around it and around it, looking at the cat.
The cat looked down, not sure really what to do. The bird, floating and flipping around. There's a wolf, there's a wolf, there's a wolf. What do we do? There's a wolf. Come down and play with me, the wolf said. I won't hurt you. I just want to be your friend. Well, Peter was watching all that was happening from behind the gate. He wanted to help his dear friends. I'm not afraid of the wolf, he said. He quickly returned with a long piece of rope and climbed the wall near one of the branches of the tall, tall tree. Well, he grabbed a branch, he swung himself onto the tree, and whispered to the bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. But be careful, don't get too close." The little bird swooped down, and as the wolf threw his head back to try to catch it, his jaws snapped open. The little bird would dart off. "How dare you tease me," said the wolf. "I don't like to be teased." And he snapped angrily. The bird would just brush the wolf's nose and then chirpily sing as it flew away. Again and again and again, the bird would fool the wolf. Up in the tree, Peter wasted no time and tied the rope around a branch. And then he waited until the wolf began to get tired and lowered the other end of the rope to catch the wolf's tail. Slowly he lowered it, and just at the right second, he pulled it! He caught the wolf's tail! The wolf pulled, and he tugged, and he pulled, and he tugged, but every time he did, the rope would just get tighter. Finally, the wolf laid down onto the ground, defeated. "Please let me go home into the deep, dark woods," said the wolf. "I will never come here again." Just then, two hunters came out of the forest. They looked about, searching for the wolf. In fact, they were a bit afraid of the wolf, to be honest. "Stop shooting, stop shooting," said Peter. "We have already caught the wolf." Peter was so proud of what he had done. Well, the hunters breathed a sigh of relief. They heard the wolf had been caught, and they decided to offer to help Peter take the wolf back to his home, as long as he was safely tied by the rope. "Follow me," chirped the bird. So they set off. First flew the bird. And then came the cat. And the hunters. Who were leading the wolf. Behind was a happy Peter. And a grandfather who exclaimed, "I knew you could do it, Peter. I always let you run into the meadow because I knew someday you would catch that wolf." But what about the duck? The duck was making such a quacking inside the wolf's stomach. The wolf felt guilty and finally coughed her up. Whereupon, she joined the procession. and waddled home. The end. And that, my friends, is the story of Peter and the Wolf. You'll notice each character had a very special instrument. What instrument did you hear for Peter? What instrument did you hear for the bird? What about the duck? Or the cat? Or the grandfather? Finally, the hunters. Well, second grade, we'll spend some time next class talking about each of those instruments. But for now, I wonder if you could think about what you think those instruments are, and maybe pick which one is your favorite. And then we can draw a picture of your favorite character beside what you think is the instrument that connects to them. So, what if you could draw a picture of your favorite character from our story, Peter and the Wolf, and a picture of the instrument that you think connects to that character? I can't wait to see what you draw. And don't worry, if you can make a guess, that's all that I'm asking. Because next time we spend time together, I'll let you know all about each of these special instruments. Well, thanks for joining me today, second grade. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time.